stupid ex-boyfriend sold like a serial about my life with him to the News of the World tabloid in England. It was so boring, they dropped it after 3 weeks, you know. And he appeared on TV commercials with my dog saying, I'm going to tell you about the real Tracy Ullman, aren't we, Lily? Oh! You know, it was like... It wasn't very scandalous, but it was... Oh, I was furious.
Where is he today?
Where is he today? Exactly, George. Where is he today and where am I?
Would you spit for me?
For you. Anything.
How are you feeling?
I feel like I've been to heaven and back.
Uh-huh.
For some reason, Doctor, I feel content. Very content.
And you won't forget to come back, hmm?
No, no. I'm going to make an appointment with your receptionist as soon as I can remember my name.
Okay. Gotta go.
Okay.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Other patients.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Excuse
still.
Me. Okay.
Hello, darling. Oh. Oh, that's a lovely temperature today. Hello, girls.
Ben, you look beautiful.
I've just had a root canal with Dr. Lindsay.
Oh, you seem awfully happy for a woman who just came from the dentist.
You know, I am. I feel very, very... I don't know. I feel... Let's just put it this way. I'm a very satisfied customer, and Dr. Lindsay himself asked me back for a post-op exam.
Technically, darling, you didn't have an op.
Oh, I'm in too good a mood to argue with you, Joby. You're always picking my language apart, and yet I win at Scrabble without fail, don't I, Bill?
The last time we played by the pool, my whole board got bleached.
Whoa,
thank you so much. I'm just saying, Fern.
Don't
when you...
say anything. Dr. Lindsay is wonderful. I'm in very good hands. End of story.
Sounds like he's using plenty of nitrous. A medication which, by the way, kills more brain cells than any other recreational drug.
He doesn't use nitrous. He uses Novocaine, miss. I read medical journals so I can argue with people who went to college for 16 years.
I like to be an informed patient.
Be as informed as you want, darling. But you will never know the pleasure that I had in having my orifice filled today. I'll see you later, okay? Oh, this healed beautifully. It was open and sulfurating this week.
Oh my God, it's him. I can't believe he had the audacity to enter a golf tournament.
Why, you know something about this man?
He used to practice in Houston, and a lot of my friends took their mouths to him. There was never any proof, but there was some evidence that he used to mix some kind of sex drug in with the Novocaine, and do you know what, to women.
He touched them in the low. Oh, my God.
Yeah, and he left the city when the authorities were catching up with him.
Oh, my God. Fern is in his chair as we speak. I gotta go. Give me the paper back.
How are you doing, Fern? Not much longer.
Oh, don't finish.
No, I'm sorry, you guys. Get in there. He's not breathing.
Oh, stop.
Fern, it's me, Jovi. Come on, wake up, Jovi.
Jovi, who invited you?
Excuse me, I am working with a patient.
Not anymore, you not. You're dental degenerate, you.
Jovi,
you were going to revoke your license. Jovi. You son of a bitch.
Let him work.
No.
Let him work.
No. Fern.
Listen to me.
That man fondled you. He fondled you.
My insurance pays for it.
Come with me, darling. Come on.
No.
Poor Fern. Touched by a dentist. Ugh. To think he touched my breasts. Even my hair renewed not to go there.
Fern, stop. What are you doing? Are you going to press charges,
right? Oh, damn straight till the day I die. Right after he replaces my temporary crown.
What are you doing?
Now,
you come out of this elevator right now.
Get away,
Jovi.
I just got to get the crown.
You're still under the influence.
I'm going up the fire stairs. You can't catch me.
Come back here, Fern.
Recently, two seniors were expelled from school just before graduation. You see, these seniors had somehow gotten a hold of this file that had all the past final exams for the whole history department, and they were selling them to the other students. But someone wrote an article about it in the school paper, and it caused this huge scandal, and they were kicked out. But now, everybody's mad at the person who wrote the article because they can't get any past tests, and they really like two students. I really thought I was doing the right thing, okay? I mean, someone's gotta start speaking to me again soon, right? Right? Ow! Oh! Stop it! Leave me alone! Ow! God! It's a journalistic integrity, you assholes! Oh, Jordan, I just love it here. Last night I went to a luau with the ugliest pig you ever saw. I've been boogie boarding and I have a hula lesson at 3:00. It's so relaxing. Oh, and Jordan, have a nice lunch without ever leaving your desk, okay? Sydney in paradise. Nice. Operator, hold all my calls. I am about to take the nap of the century. Get someone up here, Wiki Wiki!
Excuse me, Miss Cross. The hotel would be very pleased if you'd accept this basket.
The hotel would be pleased, huh?
And who the fuck is the hotel? Does that include the lobby or just these rooms that you overcharge for? Huh! You can't buy me out with bananas, Buster! This is a pubic hair in my bed, and I'm gonna find out whose it is!
I am so sorry. I've contacted everybody who worked on this floor.
Okay, let's start with you, Mr. Hotel Manager. Pull down your pants.
Here?
Oh, no! In the lobby, so everybody can get a good laugh. Come on! You, what were you doing having sex in my bed? Nobody has sex in my bed ever!
I haven't had sex in your bed, ma'am.
Then give me the name of the animal who did, huh? Oh, here they are now. Our dirty little May to December couple. You and you have turned my hotel room into a hairy hellhole.
Miss Cross, these are two of my most loyal employees.
Oh, so what are you saying? They don't have pubic hair? You two were humping in my bed, weren't you? Come on, admit it! You were humping in my bed! Don't deny it!
We are mother and son.
Oh, don't hide behind family!
Hi, I'm Richard Templeton, legal counsel for the hotel. Aloha.
And I am Sydney Cross, the fragile, traumatized, and permanently injured, and very difficult to settle with party.
Would this be the pubic hair in question?
Yes, and I have never had sex in that bed. Never.
Oh, I believe you.
Huh?
Now, why don't you just tell me what happened? And by the way, I love you on Court TV. You're always the loudest.
Don't try to sway me with your charm. Well, charm means nothing to me. Somebody has to die!
But how do you know it's not your hair that lay there on the sheet?
Yes, how do we know that?
Ha! The only way that it could have been mine is if I had big black hairs growing out of my ass, which I don't. See?
Aloha!
What? What?
Well, you have a...
What?
Well, take a look.
Good news, Mr. Templeton. Case settled. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to prepare for a hula lesson at 3 o'clock. Does anybody know where I can get my ass lasered on this island?
I'll check with the concierge.
Thank you so much. When I was in Paris, there was a beautiful young prince, whose name I won't say, engaged to the beautiful Archduchess of you never mind where. And he said to me, Madame Nadja, he said, I wish for you please to arrange my last bachelor fling. And I sent to him 3 exquisite girls.
They were sluts!
That's right, they were sluts, but they were exquisite. But it was this chambermaid at the Ritz, and she was in collusion with her low-life boyfriend, some unemployed acrobat from Corsica, and they threatened the young prince with blackmail. Oh, he was in a shit panic, but I tell him, I say, don't worry, your highness, have your fairy tale wedding. So I call the chief of police and I remind him of the Vietnamese twins, the ready whip and the Polaroids that I have in my safe. And he have the couple deported to an African colony where there is nothing, it's nothing but dirt and chickens and no toilet paper. In my business, it's not who you know, it's how much you know about them.
Why does my kitchen smell like a baseball stadium?
Oh, Olivia, don't eat that crap.
Mommy! I'll end up a fat, pimply social pariah.
Mommy, we're hungry.
Don't worry, I'll call for sushi.
Who's this?
I'm Dante. Great jacket. Andy Mealy, mister.
Yes, it is, actually.
Cool, your accent, I love it. You kind of sound like Kristen Scott Thomas, like in The Horse Whisperer. Does she base that on you?
It's possible. We had lunch together a few times.
Oh, for God's sake, don't get us started on that one.
Olivia, don't you have homework to do? I don't want to have to buy you into another school. And Dante, shouldn't you be going home to your mummy and daddy?
No, my parents are in Madagascar or Bonner somewhere.
Dante wants to stay with us for the weekend, mummy. He wants to be with a real family.
We're not a real family, darling. Olivia, come and talk to me while I change.
Mummy, this is so rude. It's obvious we're talking about him.
Olivia, I think that this boy is a little too old to be having a sleepover with a 12-year-old girl.
He's only 14.
14? Going on 35.
Stop being all American about this, Mummy. It's your Europeanness my friends find so cool.
Really?
Yes.
All right. He can stay, but he has to sleep in the spare room.
Thank you so much, Mummy.
But don't watch South Park. They say fuck all the time on that show. Good night, Olivia.
Mrs. Pillsworth, good night.
Good night. Sleep tight.
Mrs. Pillsworth. You think I can get a good night hug?
A good night hug? Come on. You're a big boy.
It's just my mom's gone. I miss her a lot. Please?
I didn't hug my own children, but, all right.
What are you...
There's a good boy. Good night. Your mummy will be home soon.
You smell so good. Is that for a cost?
Yeah, no, it is, actually.
Your skin is so soft.
I moisturize religiously. There we go. Right. Okay.
Oh, come on.
What?
Can't you get in and tell me a story?
No, I can't. Oh, my God. Oh, my God, I've got... Dante, you have to help me here. Look, it's way past your bedtime, and it's way past mine, all right? So, there we are. Tuck you in. Right. Snug as a bug in a rug.
Miss Pillsworth.
Yes. What?
You left your tea.
Oh, you drink it, it's all right. God. God, you should see this man child, Paige. He's like the model in the Calvin Klein poster, you know, with the hip bones. Mm. All shiny and hairless and new.
Janie, just... how old is he?
Oh, don't be ageist, Paige. It isn't ageism, Janie. You sound like that school teacher in Seattle who seduced her student in the back of her car. God, I'd never do that. I'd get a room at the Carlisle.
May I take your orders, ladies?
Now, I'll just have my usual egg white omelette. And I'd like the baby greens with new potatoes and a young, rare, juicy loin of veal.
Thank you.
Stop it. Hello.
Olivia!
Mummy.
What are you doing here?
I'm going to take you and your little friend Dante for ice cream. Where is he?
I don't know.
Where is he?
Ow, you're hurting me.
Hi. Oh, hi. We're going for ice cream.
Yeah.
Get in.
Great shoes, Sergio Rossi.
Right again. What?
Mummy!
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll lift Olivia up. Get in, Olivia. You'll have to move up a little bit. That's it, Dante. Ah.
Mummy, can I have some?
Mm. Oh, I'm so sorry, Olivia.
Dante and watch Nickelodeon.
No, I should be getting home.
I'll drop you.
Why do you have to go?
It's on the way to my yoga class, so.
You don't have a yoga class. The teacher comes to you.
Just drive, would you? See you later, Olivia.
Madeline, I'm home.
Who's Madeline?
I'm the housekeeper.
Are you dining in tonight, Mr. Dante?
You know, I don't know yet, Madeline. Why don't you just go to your room and watch TV? Unless you want a Coke.
No, I don't want a Coke, thank you.
You know, my dad's got, lots of liquor and stuff.
No, it's okay. I don't really want a drink.
All right, let me show you my room. What's wrong?
No, look, this is not going to happen, Dante. You're a child, and you'll tell people.
Of course they won't.
Oh, yes, you will.
I won't.
You will. You'll tell all your friends, you know, your peers in the locker room, you know. Hey, guys, I had sex with Olivia Pillsworth's mother, you know. I'll be your trophy mom, and what would it do to my daughter, you know? What would it do to my career? I mean, it'd be a scandal. I'd be finished. So...
Oh, hi. Yeah, sure, she's there. Hold on. It's Olivia.
Hello, Olivia. Yes, yes, I'm still here. I just stayed to meet his lovely housekeeper, Madeline, who's just bringing me a Coke right now. Thank you, Madeline. And I'll be home really soon. All right, darling. Oh, my God. She knows why I'm here. Oh, this is ridiculous. I feel terrible. Oh, my God, I should never have done this. I behaved disgracefully. Did your parents get this in the Sotheby's auction? Oh, Christ. Dante, I'm going to go home, and please don't try to stop me, all right?
Yes.
Dante.
Oh.
Dante. Dante. God.
Olivia.
Oh, here again, Mummy. Suppose you want to give Dante a ride.
No, darling. I'm here for you and no one else.
Really? You'll be joining the PTA next. Looks like Dante's already got a ride. Men can be such bastards.
You see so many terrible, terrible things exposed about celebrities these days. I mean, sometimes it feels like we're in a fishbowl. And there are trash reporters out there with harpoons just waiting for us to come up for air so they can stab us with their harpoons. And that's why Lonnie and Margaret and myself are having lunch today to start a campaign against these scandal vandals. And I hope you little boys with your long lenses don't show up at the Ivy restaurant at 1 o'clock. That's the Ivy on Robertson, not PCH. Because if you don't, you won't have another chance to hound us till 4 o'clock when we're having tea and privacy at the Bistro Gardens, where Barbara Eden may join the fight. That's the Bistro Gardens in Beverly Hills, not the Valley. But why am I telling you this?
Trace.
Good night, Trace.
Good night, Trace.
Go home. Go home.
Go home.